The working of the Babcock and Wilcox boiler can be easily understood by examining the flue gas circulation. The flue gas circulation is indicated in the figure as an yellow arrow. The combustion takes place and the hot flue gases move upwards. Baffles are arranged in such a manner so as to deflect the hot gases from the grate and are forced to move in the upward direction and downward directions. The hot gases rise upward and then downward and then rise up again. Finally, escapes through the chimney. The purpose of deflecting the gases is to provide maximum heating of the water tubes. Now we shall see the water circulation in the boiler. The water circulation in the boiler is indicated with blue arrows. The portion of the water tubes which are just above the furnace is heated at higher temperature than the other portion of the water tubes. So the water from this portion rises in the upper direction due to the decreased density and passes into the drum through the uptake header. Here the steam and water are separated and the steam, being lighter, is collected in the upper part of the drum. From the back portion of the drum, the water enters into the water tubes through the downtake header. Thus, a continuous circulation of water from the drum to the water tubes and water tubes to the drum is maintained. The circulation of water is maintained by convective currents and is known as natural circulation. Now we shall see the superheating of steam. The steam that is collected in the steam space gets superheated as it passes through the superheater and flows out of the boiler through the steam stop valve. The boiler is fitted with the necessary mounting such as pressure gauge, steam safety valve, steam stop valve, water level indicator and blow off cock.